So we are inside Premiere Pro and I have these three clips in my timeline. Let's focus on these two first. Let's zoom in. First, we have to make an adjustment layer. Click on this icon and adjustment layer. Hit OK. Now, drag this adjustment layer on top of our clips. From the center, we go 15 frames backward and cut it here. And again, from the center, we go 15 frames forward and cut it here. Delete the excess sides. Shift this one to the above track. Go back and drag it again, but this time from the center to the right. Cut it right here and delete the excessive part. This area became the center of our transition. The first problem we are solving is the blank space. When we start zooming in from first clip to the second, this happens. This blank space. To solve this, go to effects and search for replicate. Drag and drop this effect onto our adjustment layer. Go under effects control and under replicate, type 3. Now the problem of coverage is solved, but we encountered a new problem here. These hard edges. To solve this problem, we go to effects and search for mirror effect. Drag this to our adjustment layer. To remove these hard edge lines, we need to do a little maths here. First, we need to focus on these horizontal lines. In the reflection angle, enter 90 and use y-axis to move up and down. Let's zoom a little bit. Don't rush. These will happily merge together. See? Our first edge line is gone. Now it's time for our second horizontal line. Again, drag and drop mirror effect on the same adjustment layer. Let me close these ones so you can see clearly. This time we do the maths. We need to put minus 90 degree in the reflection angle and from y axis try to align the edges. Let's zoom in. Done. Now if we zoom out, our both horizontal edge lines are gone and it's time for our vertical lines. Again, drag and drop mirror effect on the adjustment layer. This time enter 180 degree in the reflection angle. Wait. Don't worry, nothing happened. Just need to bring our mirror image back. Use x-axis to bring the image back. Right there. Zoom in to see the edge clearly. Move it slowly. Done. Last time, drag and drop mirror effect on our same adjustment layer. Well, this time we put 360 degree in reflection angle. Let's bring our mirror image back and try to align our edges. Boom. Don't need to zoom in. I'm a professional now. Yep, flawless. We are done with this adjustment layer. Now it's time to work on the above adjustment layer. Go to effects and search for transform. Drag transform effect onto this adjustment layer. Now go in the center of the clips. Go 6 frames backward by pressing 6 times left arrow key. Start a keyframe at scale property under transform effect. Again, from the center, go 6 frames forward and add 300 in scale value. Now our transition kind of looks like this. We are definitely not done yet. First, take the playhead in the center, then go under scale dropdown. Here you find a velocity graph. We need to change it. Let's make this graph more like a mountain peak in the center. Now motion is looking good, but there's still something missing. Well, you guessed it right. It's the motion blur. We close this dropdown and check this use composition shader. And increase the shutter angle value to the max. 360 is the limit. And now if we play, our transition looks so much smoother. If I stop right there and toggle on and off, you can see the motion blur. And here you can see the magic we did to our second clip earlier. Let me show you. If we click this adjustment layer and from here turn off all mirror effects, you can clearly see the hard edges of replicate effect in the final result. That's why we used these mirror effects earlier. This right there is our main clip and this area we created using replicate and mirror effects. Now let's add this transition to our third clip in our timeline. Select both of these adjustment layers, press and hold Alt key and drag towards the third clip. Always put this area in the ending of the first clip and starting of second clip, because right there it's our transition peak. Let's see the whole thing together. Nice. But before going forward, I want to thank Pixabay. I also use their music in this video. They have free to use stock photos, videos, music, sound effects library. Yes, you heard it right. The whole freaking website is free to use. By the way, this video is not sponsored by Pixabay, but I like what they do to empower the creators like us. So thanks to Pixabay and the creators who share their work for free. Huge shout out to them. Okay, let's go. Let's create a zoom out transition using the same adjustment layers. Drag this bottom half adjustment layer to the left side. Click on the adjustment layer and go to transform and swap the position of both keyframes. Let me adjust these two 6-6 frames apart from the center. Now, if I play it back, something isn't looking right. Because as we swap the keyframes, we messed up the graph. Click on this drop down. Here you can see the graph is not looking as we want it to be. So click and drag onto these handles and again make it a mountain peak, but downward. and make sure we don't change the keyframe values while adjusting the graph. I think the zoom out transition is too quick. Let's extend both keyframes to 2 frames furthermore. Both transitions are ready to be used. As I'm watching this, I think we need to put zoom out transition first and zoom in transition second for continuity purposes. And now I'll tell you a story through these transitions. Let's play. Boys are walking in the forest, a beautiful valley. Boys are still walking. Just kidding. So there are these awesome zoom transitions. Now you can make these by yourself. Yeah, that's it. I hope you learned something new in this video. And if you are grateful for that, like this video and subscribe to this channel. Until or unless, I will see you next time. Bye.